In this video, I'll describe the RC time constant. So C here refers to a capacitor and R refers to a resistor. And to illustrate the RC time constant, I'm going to draw an example circuit. So let's go ahead and put some labels. I'm going to assume that we have an ideal voltage source. Let's call it VDC. Let's assume that we have a switch, a resistor R, a capacitor C. Let's assume that the voltage drop across the resistor is labeled V sub R, and the voltage drop across the capacitor is labeled V. Assume that the switch is thrown at time t equals zero. Then what we're going to do in this problem, the goal of the problem and the goal of the mathematical derivation that I'm about to do, is to find how V changes with respect to time. Because unlike a circuit that only has resistors and DC voltage sources, a capacitor is a circuit element that changes with respect to the time. If the capacitor is not charged, then the voltage is zero. If you start to hook some power supply to a capacitor, then the charge on the capacitor is going to grow with respect to the time and the voltage will change. So a capacitor is a device where things aren't constant with respect to time. And that's what we're going to try to work out here in this problem. So in order to find out how this voltage varies with respect to time, let's write down some of the key equations for a capacitor that might prove useful in the derivation. So first, the current in a capacitor is related to the charge on a capacitor with respect to time. It's the derivative. So as you charge the capacitor, the current changes. We also happen to know for a resistor that V equals IR. This is Ohm's law. We also know for a capacitor that charge is related to the capacitance times the voltage. So if I plug CV in for this equation, I can derive I is the time derivative of C times the voltage across the capacitor. Furthermore, I know that V is DC source minus this voltage drop R. And if I plug in for I, then I know that it's VDC minus, then I've got R, C, which are both constants, times d over dt of V. And let's take a step back now to review what we've just done. What have we done? We started with a very simple circuit, and what's constant in this circuit and what's variable in this circuit? Well, constants are the voltage on the DC power supply. Constant is the value of the capacitor that we're using. We just picked a capacitor out of a drawer and we put it into a circuit. The value of a resistor that we're using in the circuit. Everything else is a variable. So V is a variable in the circuit because it changes with respect to time. All right, VR is also a variable because when the current changes, and the current also changes with respect to time because of this relationship with the capacitor. So we took some equations for a capacitor, and we took the Ohm's law, and we combined these equations in order to get a differential equation that is a function of only one variable. So in the box, I have now only one variable. That's my V. And it appears on both sides of the equations. Everything else is a constant. What can we do with this equation? It's called a first order differential equation. And differential equations are kind of funny because generally they don't have a method to solve them all. So mathematicians have spent years, even centuries, trying to work out solutions for various forms of differential equations. Some have analytical solutions, some don't have analytical solutions, some only have numerical solutions. Some have no solutions at all. This particular equation has an analytic solution, meaning we can write down the equation of the solution. It's not so easy to derive the solution unless you already know it, but like some things in mathematics, it's very easy to prove that the solution is correct if you already know what it is. So that's the method that I'm going to use right here. I'm going to write out the solution and then I'll show you that the solution satisfies the equation. So I'm just going to label solution. V as a function of time is minus V dc times exponential e to the minus t over RC plus V dc. Now let me prove to you that this is indeed the solution to the boxed equation. Right, in order to do that, I need to take the time derivative. So let's take the time derivative dv over dt. All right, VDC is a constant. So the derivative of an exponential is the exponential, but we have the chain rule right here. So now let's plug these two into the boxed equation and make sure that it actually solves it. So I think we can see now that the left side equals the right side. So there's part of it, and there's the rest of it. All right, so I've proven that this is the correct solution right here for our differential equation. Now, how does the solution actually look? Let's graph it. Let's graph time on the horizontal axis and the capacitor voltage here. So it makes sense that when the switch is first thrown, that there won't be any voltage on the capacitor. You see, because the capacitor is not charged. So we start off with some very low voltage. It should be zero. It also makes sense that as the time gets to be very long, that the capacitor will charge, and the final voltage across the capacitor will be VDC. So I can predict that the voltage will approach VDC after a long period of time. And because it's exponential, I can see that, in fact, it's going to look like this. The reason why we call something the RC time constant is because of the ratio in the exponent. We have T over RC. It means that for the units to work out correctly, RC has units of seconds. If we change the resistor, if we change the capacitor, will the capacitor take longer or a shorter period of time to charge? If we use a larger capacitor, a larger C value, the capacitor will take longer to charge. If we use a bigger resistor, then the current is going to be less, right? So it takes longer time to build up the charge on the capacitor because the flow rate of charge into the capacitor will be less. The question is, how long does it take a capacitor to charge? If R is bigger, if C is bigger, it takes longer to charge. But practically speaking, if you wait about 5 RC time constants, then a capacitor will be about 99% charged. And that's usually a good figure of merit. If you take R times C, then you can say, okay, after about that much time, you could say a capacitor is charged. If you double the R, well, then, you know, it's not really easy to say. All right. If you enjoyed watching this video, then you might be interested in following our playlist and learning more about the fundamentals of electrical circuits.